Hey everybody, Rob from Karma Comic Chameleon coming at you with a couple of entitled parent stories. First one, entitled mother can't fathom why a disabled kid gets priority boarding. Let's jump right in. Another day, another post about people being bitchy about my disability. I get it, I guess. I'm 16 and look relatively healthy until I pass out and fall down a flight of stairs or can't breathe and end up in the ICU. Anyways, I was going back to school yesterday via plane. I was alone for this particular flight. A short summary of me, I'm 16 and have enough health issues that give me the perks of being disabled that entitled people really want. I made it through the airport so far. Air travel can be a hassle for me depending on which airport and which TSA agent I have, but it was going relatively smoothly. I have a carry-on backpack with my phone and an entire suitcase that is marked with medical equipment, please handle with care. Inside that, I have dozens of meds, nebulizer, neb vials, oxygen tubing, etc., etc. Usually that suitcase and its little tag keep me from getting shit on by the general public, but apparently not today. I'm waiting for my flight, which is scheduled to start boarding in 25 minutes exactly. This is usually when I go up to the counter and state my need for priority boarding. I answer the relevant questions, provide documentation if asked, and voila, I get a new boarding pass that gives me extra time and allows me to sit in the bulkhead seat. I'm talking with the agent and she's really sweet. So after she wraps everything up for me, we chat for a second and I talk about how crazy busy it is. I also work in customer service, so I can empathize. Entitled mother is standing behind me waiting to talk to the agent. I step aside and go over to wait for my flight. I sit down on the ground and pull out my laptop to work on my personal writing. I am wearing earbuds, but I can kind of feel that weird sensation where someone is staring at you, so I take them out and look up to see entitled mother bitching and moaning to the agent at the counter about me getting priority boarding. Entitled mother is shooting dagger glares at me. I infer that she is mad about priority boarding and therefore must be angry at how a seemingly healthy kid got to board before her and her little hellspawn. I now start to pay attention to the conversation.
Excuse me, but why does this teenager get to board before us?
I'm sorry, but that information is private.
It's not fair. She's just a liar and a freeloader. She doesn't need to board early.
The young lady has a very valid reason and is protected by airline policy. What exactly is your reasoning for requesting priority boarding?
My son right here is very young and needs help adjusting to the plane. You allow parents and kids extra time to board.
Ma'am, your son is 9 years old. That policy does not apply to him anymore.
What the f***? I want to speak to your manager.
I step in to intervene because I work in customer service and have dealt with many Karens. It's easier to have another person on your side. Excuse me, ma'am. I am allowed early boarding due to federal law and airline policy. Please do not take it out on the agent right here. If you have an issue with my boarding, you can speak to me instead.
Exactly why the f*** can you board early? You don't meet any of the policies. Grow up and take some responsibility.
I don't know where the hell she got that from. Being I am 16, traveling across the country alone with a disability, I'm pretty damn responsible. I am disabled. I got plenty more reasons to board early than you and your kid. If you so like, I will board normally and be unable to inform the flight crew of my disability and proper procedure to help me when I am in distress, which means we might have to make an emergency landing. So sure, you'll like that because it will delay your arrival in state by a day. Would you like me to do so? I'm standing there looking like I give no f**ks per usual and have my award-winning RBF. Entitled mother looks taken aback and is an epitome of the shocked Pikachu meme.
But you aren't old. You can't be disabled if you aren't old.
Well, for your information, I am going back to school a few days early so that I can spend 3 days in the hospital seeing a variety of specialists, having a battery of tests, and possibly having a feeding tube placed. Disability does not discriminate based on age. Now, if you will excuse me, I'm going to sit back down before I pass out.
That shut Entitled Mother up, and she slunk back to her row of chairs to sit and wait for her boarding zone to be called. I wanted a few minutes, and then got up to be at the very front of the priority boarding line. I enjoyed a peaceful flight, and enjoyed seeing Karen be stuck in the back of the plane, waiting to deplane, while I was the first one off. So, Entitled Mother wants priority boarding for her child who has no issues, where she can't understand why somebody else who has a disability needs priority boarding. Guys, remember, disabilities aren't always visible. And you definitely don't receive any kind of priority treatment just because you popped out a crotch goblin. On to our next story. Entitled Mother throws a tantrum over airplane seat. Let's jump right in. We had two flights today on Southwest Airlines. For those who aren't familiar with how Southwest operates, I'll give some information on the process. You check into your flight 24 hours in advance, and your check-in time determines your boarding position. Seats cannot be pre-selected, so your best bet is to be on their priority list or pay for early check-in to get a better spot in line. After I attempted to check into husband's and my flight, Southwest would not allow me to check in, but did allow my husband to check in. I immediately knew I was on SSSS status, meaning that I was selected for a random additional security check. This forced me to wait until the next day, when it was time to fly, to be able to check in and receive boarding passes. Husband had a better spot in line for boarding than I did. I was at the end of the line. But both the service desk and boarding clerk told husband to save a seat for me since he would board first and I would be held up doing the secondary check along with a few other passengers. After finally getting to get on the plane and waiting in the aisle line for other passengers to find seats, I spotted husband in the very back row. However, there was a woman crying loudly near the lavatory. As I go to take my seat, the following ensues. The first part of this conversation was filled in through husband. Is this seat taken? Yes, I'm sorry, it's for my wife. Entitled mother finally getting to kid and realizing the seat was already saved. Well, where is your wife? Has she even boarded yet? Yes, she's right there. Points to me at the midpoint of the plane, waiting for people to sit so I can get to him. Entitled mother immediately starts loudly crying and trying to tell flight attendant what's going on. I take my seat, and she passively aggressively states, "Well, I'm glad you were able to save a seat for your wife, and I won't be able to sit with my kid." Loud sniffling noises. "It's okay, Mom. I'm fine sitting here." I quickly turned to husband to ask what in the hell was going on. Apparently, kid boarded the plane before her and had tried to save a seat for her mother. After husband told her that he had the seat saved, she sat on the aisle seat and waited for entitled mother. Entitled mother still bawling loudly and attempting to create a scene while talking to a passenger nearby. "He shouldn't be able to save a seat when I need to sit next to my daughter. I don't know what I'm going to do. This is ridiculous." "Ma'am, why didn't you tell the staff before boarding began that you wanted to try and get on with your daughter so they could help you sit together?" "They wouldn't let me." I couldn't fully hear what came next, but she alluded to something about her not being 16 years old. Flight attendant had a confused face. "Okay, ma'am, I will go make an announcement to see if anyone would be willing to change seats for you both." As the flight attendant left, a woman offered entitled mother her seat, which was diagonal from the one kid was sitting in next to us. This seemed to be okay with her, so she took it. She continued the melodramatic sniffling for around 10 minutes after taking her new seat. Kid was actually really nice to sit next to. And I even helped her out with a few things, which is why I didn't want to put the entitled title to her name. Now, for clarification, I was only a minute behind entitled mother as far as taking seats, so this happened in a few minutes maximum. Husband wasn't trying to be rude, but he wanted to ensure that I knew what was going on before offering the seat to them. I would have gladly moved to allow entitled mother and kid to sit together had she not decided to immediately throw a tantrum to try and get what she wanted. Both husband and me immediately decided that there were many options available for her to find a way to accommodate her needs, and she insisted on going with making a scene. We weren't going to condone her behavior by complying. When we made it to our connecting airport, we found that entitled mother was actually on our next flight as well. When it came time to board, we noticed something peculiar. Kid was one of the first in line for boarding, while Entitled Mother was two spots ahead of us, last in the second boarding group. Entitled Mother was planning on using her daughter to save her a seat, as she had better choices of seats. This was the very thing she had attempted to do beforehand, but didn't count on the fact that someone wouldn't immediately bend to her needs. Again, I know this wasn't as dramatic or intense as most of the stories, but this was the first genuine experience I ever had with an entitled mother. What I'm not understanding of this story is why entitled mother and kid were in completely different boarding order. Were they not checked in at the same time? Did the parents not check in the kids' tickets at the same time as they checked in their own? That just seems kind of odd to me. I want to thank both of the OPs for posting their stories to the Entitled Parents subreddit. You can visit them at the links in the description below. Please go there and give them an upvote. Once again, this is Rob from Karma Comic Chameleon saying thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please hit that subscribe button, drop a like, and share it with your friends. And we'll see you in the next one.